Schwartz and Brian Benefitemi. I'm Blake Suniga, and we're glad to have you along for the ride. Our starting lineups, a look at the matchups here and who we'll see for our starting five for both teams. And each of these teams boasting a veteran roster. What's the value of experience in this league?
It's huge. I mean, frankly, it is very rare to see a young, inexperienced team win consistently at this level.
Yeah, even developing teams can benefit from those sage veterans, helping to coach up the newcomers and kind of show them the ropes.
Now here's Vandersloot. Pass to Laney. That shot off. Great D that time from Natasha Cloud. Copper, covered by Ionescu. Here's Allen. Good, and the assist goes to Kalia Copper.
It's easy to see Copper's phenomenal fundamentals. When she sees a wide-open shooter, she makes sure they get the ball.
Vandersloot outside. Pass to Stewart. And she takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Ran her defender straight into that screen to open up the lane to the hoop.
And we're about 1 minute into the first. Copper outside. Over Ionescu. Off to a good start as she hits her first shot attempt.
I like how Copper lets the game come to her. When the mid-range game opens up, she takes it.
Picked by Jones. Ionescu up top. With the floater. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. Pass to Cloud. Back to Taurasi. Screen by Griner. Fires from the line. And Laney pulls it down. Courtney Vandersloot for three. Here's Jones. And that's good. A nice job on the glass, and they pick up the two on the second effort.
As complete a player as they come, Jones has no problems hitting the glass hard, turning misses into makes.
Now here's Copper. Over Ionescu. And the basket by Copper. Here's Vandersloot. It's a three-point game. Ionescu outside. Back to Vandersloot. Laney, pass to Vandersloot. Out to the right wing. Shot clock at five. Score the basket. Nice shot after missing her first attempt. Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Copper outside. Over Ionescu. And it's good off the glass.
What an instinctual nose for the ball. Griner just cleans up the glass so efficiently.
Vandersloot outside. Stewart, she's covered by Taurasi. Vandersloot outside. Pass to Ionescu. Shot clock at six. And she uses the glass on the layup.
Yeah, you know, contact can't slow Ionescu down. She sticks with her inside shot and finishes strong.
And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first. Diana Taurasi on the wing. For three. And it's Ionescu with the rebound. New York trailing here. Vandersloot outside. Back to Ionescu. Stewart. Ionescu right side. Laney outside. Puts one up from 19. And it's Phoenix with the rebound.
Well, I mean, to me at least, Brian, it looked like it was going to be an easy 2 points there.
You're right, Tim. And she's got some angry words for herself after that miss.
Now here's Griner. Loud outside. Copper. Here's Taurasi. Good. Coming off the assist by Kalia Copper.
Looking comfortable operating in the post. Taurasi has a great sense of when to attack from this area on the court.
Now Ionescu. New York calls timeout. Liberty making a switch here. Here's Dodikish.
The three ball.
And it's Brittany Griner with the rebound. Outside Cunningham. And the foul called on Ionescu. That's her first foul. And here's Sutton. Pass to Griner. Second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Always easily above 50% shooting from the floor. Griner is deadly inside.
Now Burke. Now Dodikish. Here's Ionescu. 6 to shoot. Over Copper. And the basket by Ionescu.
You don't see handles like that every day. Ionescu is so skilled at breaking down her defender.
Copper outside. Sutton. Back to Copper. Goes up from the top of the key. It's rebounded by Sabrina Ionescu.
You just assume she's going to knock those down when she's as open as she was there.
On the mark with the 15-footer.
A shot that looks almost automatic for Ionescu has total confidence in her shooting ability.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Mercury out in front. They lead by 1. Quarter number 2 coming up right after this break. Don't go anywhere. And the second quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And what do you guys think about the Mercury here in this one?
It's been a solid first half for them offensively, really in tune with each other.
Yeah, good ball movement, and it's paid off on the scoreboard for sure.
Phoenix leading. Here's Sutton. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Copper outside. The pick by Ball Queen. Pulls up from the top of the key. And the basket by Copper. Here's Dodikish. Pass to Burke. Davis with it. As we head towards the 30th season of the WNBA, what stands out to you guys in terms of the state of the league?
Well, to me, it's just how great a position the league is in. We've got exciting young stars, and ratings records being set every single year, and just the overall feeling around the W.
I sense that too, that we're all building something, and this thing is continuing to improve. That's what's the most exciting thing for me. I think the best is yet to come.
Here's the three. That's her second shot and her second basket. My math says that's 2 for 2.
And Thornton is such a smart player, recognizes overcommitments from the defense and gets it to her open teammates.
Now here's Cunningham. Pass to Copper. Shoots the three. Again, Kalia Copper missing. New York in the lead. Albert. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And it's Cunningham with the rebound.
Those chances, usually they're 2 points for her. The D, I guess, did just enough to bother her.
Pass to Ball Queen. Cunningham sets a screen. To the inside. The lead pass was put in just the right spot to produce the layup.
Well, not just a perimeter threat. Cunningham is also dangerous on the interior.
On offense, here the Liberty. Here's Dodikish. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in this second quarter. Inside. Three on the clock. Launches it. And again, it's the Liberty from deep.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Timeout called from Mercury.
Yeah, coach wants to get everybody on the same page out there and maybe change up some things as well.
Yeah, that's probably a good timeout. You might as well talk things through.
And kind of change that game plan as well.
The Liberty making a switch here. On the wing, Natasha Cloud. Diana Taurasi on the wing, defended by Stewart. Here's Taurasi. It's good from about 19 feet.
I know it's not in vogue to shoot the mid-range, but guess what? Diana Taurasi does not care at all about that. She loves this area.
Now here is Ionescu. 6 points for her. Stewart inside. She's covered by Taurasi. Offensive board. Shot's good by Jones.
A premier interior scorer, Jones's physical presence is enough to intimidate defenders.
Pass to Taurasi. And almost 4 minutes gone in the second quarter of play. Here's Griner. Goes right through for bucket number three. She's a perfect 3 for 3.
She's got a great read of where that miss was going, and that enabled her to be the first player to it and get the putback.
Pass to Jones. Now Ionescu. Burke. Clock at 4. Here's Stewart. She's covered by Taurasi. Stewart with the bucket.
Yeah, nice idea. Give the ball to Stewart late in the clock. Let her create. Sometimes basketball, it's not rocket science.
Now here's Taurasi. Let's the floater go. No good on that shot. Pass to Ionescu. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
You have to make sure your feet are set. When you set those screens, they'll get you for it.
I thought maybe she was set. Now, I know that's a difficult call to make, but I think maybe they got that one wrong.
Taurasi outside. Back to Cloud. Pass to Cunningham. Sutton
puts up a three, cans it from downtown.
Well, Cunningham is such an impressive distributor, and passes like these are why her teammates love playing with her.
Outside, Stewart
got a piece of it.
And here's Sutton.
Shoots over Vandersloot.
Sutton with the bucket.
Wily vet Taurasi. Incredible court vision.
Here's Vandersloot. They trail by one. Pass to Ionescu.
Shoots over Cloud.
And the basket by Ionescu.
She will make you throw your hands up as a defender. It just frustrates you because you just don't know how to play her.
Now here's Taurasi. Over Stewart. The shot by Taurasi, no good. Vandersloot outside. Now here's Cunningham.
She got it!
That counts, count it, count it.
Just in time.
A miracle heave to finish off that quarter. How'd you get that to go down?
Fantastic shot.
And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. Mercury out in front. They're up by 2. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. Welcome back. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. Sabrina Ionescu really making a difference out there.
What I noticed more than anything about her first half offense was she didn't waste her opportunity. She made just about every good look she had.
And they were pretty much all good looks. I mean, her shot selection has been phenomenal throughout the game.
And it's been a back and forth game with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter getting started here.
Copper outside.
Over Ionescu, and the basket by Copper.
And this is Kalia Copper's role, guys. She's out here to score and take shots like this.
Ionescu outside.
And for coaches in the league, what would you two say is the biggest challenge?
Well, to me, it's not about what happens on the floor. It's not about even the X's and O's. It's about the locker room, keeping your players happy, making sure there are some good vibes.
And for me, when we talk about hoops, it's about defense, getting a system in place and getting your players to buy in. Not everyone wants to play defense, but if you can get them to, you will be rewarded.
Now here's Copper. 8 points for her.
And she makes that one. And if you're just joining us, we've played just over a minute here in the third.
Ionescu outside.
Four on the clock. Courtney Vandersloot for three. It's rebounded by Phoenix. Rossi outside. From downtown, and again, Phoenix with the triple.
Well, she's the all-time leader in threes made in league history. You might not want to let Diana Taurasi get off shots from range.
Now here's Laney.
Ionescu.
Back to Laney.
Ionescu outside. Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
On the wing, Kalia Copper.
Guarded by Jones.
Cloud outside. Taurasi. Copper outside.
She hits it just before the shot clock expires.
We've seen that Copper is capable of big things on offense. And I'm starting to think this is going to be one of those nights.
The Liberty Trail.
Ionescu outside.
Out of bounds, it'll go to the Mercury.
The National Player of the Year in college, Sabrina Ionescu was a triple-double machine at Oregon.
Shattering the all-time record for collegiate triple-doubles, Ionescu was the first ever 2,000 points, 1,000 rebounds, 1,000 assists player ever, and she has brought that versatility from the college game here to the pro game.
Now here's Copper.
They lead by eight. That's the biggest margin of the game. That one goes. Count it.
This is a nice third quarter surge they've got going on right now.
Yeah, and it's a great time to get hot just as we get into the meat of the second half.
Absolutely. Build some distance. Try to get things going.
Here's Ionescu. She's got eight.
In. It's her fifth field goal, and she's shooting a hot 71%, 5 for 7. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter.
Copper outside.
So she gets the whistle, contact on the way up, two shots next.
And it's going to be on Sabrina Ionescu.
Aggressive drive by Copper, going right inside and picking up a good foul.
And this is our first free throw of the game.
The first one falls.
Well, the growth that Kalia Copper has shown over her career is remarkably incredible. She never stopped looking for ways to sharpen her skills, and all of that hard work, it's really paid off, guys.
That's also good, so she hits them both. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter play now.
Get there, get there. I got you.
Pass to Burke. And here's Ionescu. Stewart with the ball. Five to shoot. Shoots over Taurasi. And the Liberty getting another bucket right there.
The mid-range jumper, something I love to see. Stewart's game is multifaceted. And I'm really not surprised to see her knock that one down.
Now here's Copper. She's got 16. That's some solid defense from Jonquel Jones. Laney with it. Ionescu up top. Back to Laney. Burke, Laney outside. There's the triple. Allen with the rebound. Phoenix leading. Pass to Sutton. On the wing, Kalia Copper. Shoots from the line. And a rebound by Brianna Stewart. Here's New York now. Now Laney. Stewart, she's covered by Taurasi. From about 16, Sabrina Ionescu from outside. That one's off. She's made five and missed three now. Taurasi outside. Here's Allen. Pass to Griner. Here's Sutton.
From the arc, drops in the tray.
On offense, here are the Liberty. They trail by 11. Ionescu outside.
Soft touch off the glass.
So dangerous on the drive. Ionescu is superb at seeing avenues to the rim and attacking.
The third quarter comes to a close. It's the Mercury. They lead by 9. And we're just moments away from the start of quarter number 4. Stay with us. And the final period of play just about to get started here. And it's New York's ball. 9-point game. And here's Burke. Pass to Vandersloot. Let's it go from deep. Good on the triple.
And Vandersloot can make this shot, especially when the defense isn't guarding her very tightly.
Now Sutton. Vandersloot defending. Cunningham sets a screen.
Here's Cloud. Count it from 12 feet.
The deeper we get into this game, the more offense we're seeing.
Yeah, both of these teams are firing on all cylinders right now. I love it.
Now here's Vandersloot. Pass to Ionescu. There's a screen. Shoots over Cloud. Again, the Liberty, good for two.
What a scoring display we're seeing from Ionescu right now, putting her expansive offensive skill set on full display.
Here's Cloud. And the ball is tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. Pass to Sutton. Now Cunningham. Cloud with it.
Four on the shot clock.
Reiner. Unable to get that one to go.
You see defenders afraid to get in her way a lot of times when she's on her way to the bucket, but not that time.
Vandersloot outside. Now Ionescu.
Shoots over Cloud.
Ionescu can't get it to go. Phoenix with the ball. They've led by as many as 11 points. Pass to Cloud. Over Ionescu. A nice shot by Cloud.
So deadly in the pick and roll. Cloud can pass it out of this set, and she can score it too. A real dual threat point.
And here's Burke.
Takes the three. And again, it's the Liberty from deep.
I mean, that shot just becomes effortless for her when the defense is so relaxed like that.
Timeout called. Mercury. And when we talk about the best passer in league history, it's got to be Courtney Vandersloot, right?
Oh, yeah. And honestly, it's not even a huge debate. Vandersloot normally leads the league in assists, has the best career average ever by far, probably the most fun player to run with.
Just under 2.5 minutes gone by now in the final quarter. Three, Diana Taurasi hits the three-point bomb.
Talk about falling asleep on defense. I don't know how you can give a shooter like her that much space from beyond the arc.
Now here's Vandersloot. Pass to Jones. Cloud pulls it in. Phoenix leading. Now here's Copper. Cloud. Allen with it. Now Taurasi. And the Mercury, another three. Well, maybe the question facing coaches and front offices building a team, do you go big or small these days?
Yeah, I'm going to cheat here. I'm going to say both. Having different lineups can really help your team. I like teams that can do both, depending on the opponent, depending on the situation.
Oh, come on, Tim. I'm not going to skirt the question. I'm going small. Push the pace, and of course we all know, three is greater than two. Plus, it's just fun to play small ball.
Everything they put up is falling in, and that score keeps climbing.
And that is one demoralized set of defenders out there.
Now, here is Ionescu. out to Vandersloot.
To halt the run.
Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Such a sharpshooter. That's almost a layup for her. So wide open.
Rossi outside. The three. They get it back. Loud outside. The three. That's good. And so Brittany Griner gets the assist.
Wow. Cloud looked almost automatic on the catch and shoot. No hesitation at all. Did you guys see that?
Now here is Ionescu. Drops in the layup for two.
You know, she's done a ton to help this team, but if they're going to come back, she needs to do even more.
And it's the Mercury with the ball. And they can take their time on this possession.
It wouldn't be a bad idea. Give themselves a little bit of a break.
Rossi outside. Shot from free throw range. And the Mercury tack on two more.
Enjoy it. Went on. No one scores like Diana Taurasi. She has the most 20-plus point seasons in league history.
Now here is Ionescu. They have a really solid lead at this point.
Definitely. On the other side, really not much resistance put up.
Rossi outside to the middle. Reiner not going to go that time. Good defensive work by Jonquel Jones. Here's Stewart. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
This had come earlier, they might have been able to get back into it.
100%. They needed this a lot sooner than they got it.
Yeah, where was this earlier?
And they are this close to putting it away.
Yeah, and they don't need to do anything special. Just take time off the clock. And most importantly, don't turn it over.
Yeah, don't pull a Tim. Now here's Taurasi. Yes, it's good.
I'd say that's it, guys. They're not coming back from this one.
Nope. Any chance of that happening has long since passed.
And we're still here.
Laney, good.
Shooting more threes in her career now. Benaja Laney, much more comfortable from deep.
Cloud with it. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Down low. Reiner, shot's good.
Terrific run to put this ball game away.
And now let's see just how much longer they keep that foot on the accelerator.
Yeah, got to keep it on the accelerator to the finish line.
And the basket by Ionescu.
No hesitation on the pull-up, Jay. One of Ionescu's greatest strengths as a scorer is her tremendous decisiveness.
And so it's Phoenix with the W. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
It makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in a good flow, you felt like they never had any doubts that they come out on top.
And that's a wrap, everyone.